Let's have a look at x of 1. So what is x of 1? So the x of 1 represents the lowest frequency possible. So why is that? So if we looking at our inverse Fourier transform here, and we're getting a term out there which is e to j 2 pi n divided by n. And so this gives us the following result, that if this goes to n minus 1, then depending on this coefficient here, if it's real or complex, that we are either getting something like that, or we are getting a curve like this, which fits exactly in here. This is directly obvious here. So we have got this ratio of small n by capital N. So capital N is just the whole length of this sine wave here. And then we're using n as an index here, which is running from 0 to n minus 1. And then this gives us obviously exactly one revolution of our phasor here. Okay, so let's bring octave in here and have a look if it actually works. So here we've got octave, and so let's first create an empty vector x equals zeros, so 100 elements we take. Let's check that x is really just zeros. Here we go, loads of zeros. And so now what we would like to do is creating the lowest frequency. So we set x of 2 to 1. Remember, MATLAB starts its index numbers with 1, so therefore our x of 1 is actually 2 here. So maybe I should write 1 plus 1, and the 1 comes from the stupid MATLAB convention. So let's set this here to 1 and now do a inverse Fourier transform of that. And let's have a look what we are getting here. Let's plot the real part of that and bring it here over. Okay, so what we see here now is that we are getting here in the real part a beautiful cosine wave. And let's have a look at the imaginary part. And in the imaginary part, we are getting a beautiful sine wave out there. What is what we expect? Remember, if I get rid of this here, and move the sine wave a bit to the side here, so we've got this complex with this setting the x of 1 to 1. So we are generating this complex phasor here, and this is nicely rotating in this complex plane here, and it's doing exactly one rotation over the revolution from 0 to n minus 1. So we could also draw here this at the side here, this our complex diagram here, imaginary. And so this term here, 2 pi n divided by n, this rotates exactly one time around here. So it starts here from n equals 0, and then when it's here, it's at n equals n minus 1. So that's the idea behind that. Okay, so this was lowest frequency. So let's have a look now at the highest possible frequency.